Has Viagra or Cialis stopped working for you? Is it possible that you can get used to it? Did you make a mistake? These are important questions and I will address them all in this video. But sometimes subtle changes can have that effect. Changes that are so subtle you didn't even think about them. I'm Dr. Stefan Buntrock, board certified urologist and specialist in sexual health. Throughout my professional career, I have witnessed a lot of scenarios when it comes to PDE5 inhibitors. Nobody really talks about it, but there is a chance drug tolerance is not your fault. It's the drugs. How? Wait and see. But let's quickly go through some basic concepts. Viagra, Cialis, Levitra, Stendra, and their generics, sildenafil, tadalafil, vardenafil, they all belong to a group of medications by the name of PDE5 inhibitors. PDE5 is the name of an enzyme. If you spell it out, it reads phosphodiesterase type 5. I don't want to make this a boring lecture, but have you ever thought about the switch in your body that switches off an erection? I mean, it's logical. If you can switch it on, there must be some way to switch it off. Or you would get an erection once and forever. PDE5 is your off switch. I think now it becomes clear what these drugs do. They sabotage the off switch. But that doesn't mean it's all automatic. You still have to shift gears the old-fashioned way to get an erection in the first place. So, are these drugs reliable? Absolutely. If you are a so-called responder, they work their magic every time. However, some men will note the need for higher doses. Roughly 1 in 5 men reports that Viagra or Cialis works less well over time. How can this be possible? Is it possible at all? Does the body get used to Viagra over time? Simple answer, no. The body doesn't adapt. There is something else that happens. But before I dive into the details, let's shift gears for a second. If you like my content, please subscribe to UroChannel. If you think this video is of value for you, give it a thumbs up. It shows your appreciation for my content. It is digital applause that doesn't cost you any money. Activate notifications so you never miss out on new content. And speaking of content, this is real medical experience talking here. I don't copy from anybody, but I can't help the impression of other channels copying from me. But hey, that's a truth all successful products have to face nowadays. So if you want to save a few bucks and start to buy your Viagra online instead of going to the pharmacy, you may order yourself a copy. Did you know that up to 50% of PDE5 inhibitors sold online are fake? Why does that matter? Because if your pill isn't working, maybe it never had a chance to work. These copies often contain too little of the substance, or none at all. Now you know. It may actually not have anything to do with you, it may be the product itself. By the way, according to tests, the risk of being sold forged drugs in a stationary pharmacy is less than 0.001%. That's in Europe. Estimations are less than 0.01% in Australia or the US. Okay, let's shift the angle, but stick to drugs and pharmacies. I'm talking about other medications interfering with the drug effects of Viagra and the likes. It can be a simple beta blocker. I mean, high blood pressure is everywhere. Beta blockers are highly effective. Sometimes you just can't get around them. Beta receptors are molecular switches in the membranes of your cells. You need them for a lot of functions. Unfortunately, they are vital for erections. If you block them, erections will become weaker. It then appears that Viagra is losing its effect. It's not drug failure, it's a drug interaction. If beta blockers can't be avoided, nebivolol may be a good choice since it doesn't have that effect. Talk to your doctor about it. Not every patient is suitable for that change. Sometimes you just have to take your medicine. Did you know that there are drugs that fire up your liver? PDE5 inhibitors are eliminated from the body by the liver. A liver on high gear eliminates them faster. Then you may get the impression that your Viagra or Cialis failed you. A drug quite often prescribed is dexamethasone. It's a kind of cortisone. If you think you've never heard about it, think twice. No Hollywood movie about climbing in the Himalayas without this famous quote, "I want my Dex!" Yep, that's the very one. And then, if you are a fan of natural remedies, St. John's wort will have the same effect. It makes the liver eliminate Viagra faster. Let's stay with medications for a second. There's another group that can quietly ruin your sexual response and your trust in pills like Viagra or Cialis. I'm talking about antidepressants, especially SSRIs. These drugs are incredibly helpful for many people. They lift mood, reduce anxiety, and help stabilize mental health. But they come with a price, and nobody really talks about it. SSRIs can reduce libido, delay orgasm, or flatten arousal altogether. They don't block erections directly, but they mute the signal that usually leads there. And if there's no signal, PDE5 inhibitors have nothing to amplify. What makes it tricky? You may still feel desire in your head, but your body doesn't respond the way it used to. You take the pill, nothing happens, and you blame the pill. This isn't drug failure, it's drug interference. Now here's where it gets even more confusing. Some men are prescribed SSRIs for performance anxiety, but while it helps with the fear, it may also take away the very thing they were trying to protect, their ability to feel. If you're interested in why Viagra may stop working, I have several videos about it on my channel. Let me quickly summarize some important points from those vids. Aging and disease burden may make your body less responsive to PDE5 inhibitors. It's not just about age, it's about lifestyle. The wrong foods, too little movement, they promote high blood pressure, vascular damage, and hormonal changes. Obesity lowers testosterone. So yes, it may feel like Viagra has stopped working, but what really changed is the system it works in. Want more details? These two videos will give you more information. Medical information online? It's a swamp, but I know the way, so follow me.